Hello, everybody, and I'm really excited to be contributing to our No Device Wednesday afternoons, when we're going to be using our time to create a large piece of artwork to say thank you to the NHS for all the superb work that they're doing looking after us and looking after everybody who's been ill with COVID. We're really, really keen and enthusiastic to be able to present the Salford Hospital with our huge piece of artwork. And of course, each of us are going to be able to make a small contribution. And we've asked you, haven't we, to design something for the NHS on a cream piece of yellow fabric. So let me show you mine. Okay, so this is mine. So I'm going to move the camera so it's looking at this and not at me. It's a bit like a heart attack. You don't want to see me, you want to see this. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. So everybody look down. Okay, so here is my cream square. And I don't know if you can see, because it's quite bright in here, the love heart that I've drawn off in pen there. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to sew with red ribbon the outline of that square like that. I'm not going to do it now, get one of that out of that, because it will take me a little while and you'll get bored. But if you get the idea, so that piece of ribbon will go on that side and this piece of ribbon will go on this side. And you can probably guess why I've picked to do some sewing, because everybody knows that I'm not that great at drawing and painting, and I'm much better at things like sewing and baking. So I'm going to sew that on there like that. So if you imagine a red outline of a heart. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to use all of these fantastic buttons here, and they're all red or different shades of red, and they're all different shapes and sizes. Some are really interesting and shiny, like this one. Can you see that one there? Some are really interesting shapes and textures, like this one. Some are really tiny, like this one. So I'm really going to have to focus when I sew these on. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to collage these buttons. I'm going to sew them on to fill my love heart like this. I'm going to start off with the big red ones. So I'm going to do most of the love heart with these big red ones. You know what I might do is I might put a lovely one there, like that, the top of that love heart there. And then I'm going to sew all of these round here like this, within that red ribbon, if you remember, keeping inside the lines like that. So I want to start with the big red ones first, like that, to get the shape of my love heart. I like that one. Look, that one there, that one there. Obviously, when I sew these, it'll take me a little bit longer. And then I'm going to fill the middle of the love heart with these smaller buttons, like this. And as I'm sewing, I'm going to be thinking about all the people that the NHS have helped, particularly in these tricky times. Oh, I might have to go back into my bag over there some more. The NHS have helped. I know we all know somebody who's been poorly with COVID, or who's needed the NHS, something like that. So if you can imagine, that's my love heart there, and the ribbon will go around the outside, and that will be my contribution to a much bigger piece of artwork. So like me, you can sew, you can stitch, you can draw, you can paint, you can use fabric pens, you can use tie-dye. I know the other teachers have put lots of lovely ideas as part of this video. Be inspired, and I look forward to seeing all the fantastic pieces that you come up with. Okay, see you soon.
Hi everyone, Mrs. Buckley here. My daughter is demonstrating an example of something you could do for the quilt. She is drawing a simple message in the middle that she's going to leave clear so that you can see the colour of the material. And then she's going to do a design on the background using different shades of blue. We chose blue because this is our favourite colour. Remember, guys, that you need to keep the colour that you choose to one colour rather than a mixture of colours, please. She's using pencil to draw the design, and then she's going to go over in felt tip. You could do this using paint, you could use it using fabric pens, whatever you've got to hand would be fine. Now she's starting to colour the background of her design. She's going to colour wavy stripes through the background using different shades of blue. As you can see, the message that she's leaving blank is nice and clear with the gorgeous blue coloured background.
Hello, nursery. Right, so this week you will be receiving in your packs a piece of material like this. Everybody in school is going to be getting one. And we're all going to be decorating it as a thank you to the NHS. You can pick any colour you would like. You can do it in rainbow form. I've just picked purples. Or, like I said, you can do it in rainbows. So I've tried to think of an easy way that you can decorate at home. And what I've done is come up with some stencils. I've cut out some cardboard shapes. I've done a square, a heart, a rectangle, and a circle. And what I've done is I've just put it onto the material and I've used a felt tip, put it down, hold it in place, make sure your child's just holding it with one hand and doing it with the other, stenciling around it and then colouring it in. You can do that with felt tip, or I've done it with felt tip there to show you. I have done it with chalk, you might have chalk at home, and I've also done it with a crayon, so I've come up with different kind of patterns there and styles. And then Mrs. Cunningham kindly cut out the letters NHS for me, and I have drawn around them. So instead of filling it in, I've drawn around them so that when this gets, it's upside down, when it gets sewn together with all the rest of the schools, we will be able to say a big thank you to the NHS, and hopefully everyone will have picked different colours and we'll have a lovely rainbow quilt to show for this whole lockdown. Okay, so if you don't like this way, how it's done, then reception are gonna post a video, year one, year two, all teachers are posting a video of what they're doing with their sheets. Okay, good luck.
Hi everyone, so this is my piece of fabric. I'm going to use the color green, because that's my favorite. Now, it's for the NHS, so I think I'll write a message. I'm using fabric pens for this. We got thank you. I'm gonna put thank you. Now I'll I think I'll colour all that in, okay. But to decorate a bit more, I'm gonna get my other fabric pen out and let's draw some hearts around the outside. Some bigger, some smaller. Take your time with this, it's not quite like drawing on paper. There we go. So I'm not quite finished, I'm now going to colour it in. I'm going to use both the pens just so I get that nice pattern of green on there. Okay, and I think that'll look really good. So have a go at home.
Sit in the kitchen and talking for hours. You always show up at the perfect time.
no one born with x-ray eyes. There's no way to know what's on my mind, but you always say the words that save my life. I've got friends that will run to walls. I've got friends that will fly once cold, when I've no superhuman, but you got the strength to carry me through with my shield of steel when I'm too weak to fight. Yes, you are. And that day my mother died, and you held me up and you wiped my eyes. It was in that moment when I realized that I've got friends that will run through walls. Yeah, I've got friends that will for my happiness and sad for my sadness. Piss me off, you're mad for my madness. Ever since we were young, help me rise from the ashes. If I fall from the sky, you'll catch me. Cause friends don't let you do stupid things. Oh, friends don't let you do stupid things. Oh, friends don't let you do stupid things. Alone, alone.
Okay, hi everybody. So we've been asked to all make a design for the NHS. We've all got a piece of fabric in our packs this week, and you're all going to decorate them and make them beautiful. And they are going to be a gift for a hospital, just to say thank you for the NHS staff that have been helping us lately. This is mine. So if you would like to make one that looks like this, watch my video. Okay, first, I just need a couple of simple things. The first thing that you will need is shaving foam. Good idea first is to take your jumpers off, just have a short sleeve t-shirt on, or roll your sleeves up. Then on a tray, squirt the shaving foam. Mummies and daddies can help you. Here we go. And I'm just going to brush it about a little bit, just to spread it like this. When you put your shaving foam on your tray, you then need to pick which colour of paint you would like. I'm going to choose red. So put a little bit of red paint on the shaving foam. There we go. I'm going to choose yellow and orange. And by doing this, by mixing it with the shaving foam, it will give you a marbled effect, and that's how I've made it look like lots of different colours. I think it looks quite nice. Orange, just a little bit. Okay, now I'm not going to mix really quickly, because it will just all mix together and make the colour brown. So I'm just going to spread the paint ever so gently using my paintbrush. So I'm not giving it a big mix, I'm just spreading it about a little bit. And maybe we could use, should we use a bit of blue as well? That would look nice. My blue's nearly empty, I'll give it a shake. Ooh. I've used most of this today. That'll do. Okay, so now all of my colours are ready. Can you see how it looks a bit marbled? Looks quite nice, doesn't it? What you then need to do is move your paintbrush to one side and get your piece of fabric. Put your fabric on top of the shaving foam and just press it down ever so gently. And to spread the paint around, if you use your fingers like this, spread the paint under the fabric, it will make sure that everything's painted, it'll look really nice. So I'm just spreading it with my fingers. And then when you lift it up, you'll see, shall we reveal it? Doesn't that look beautiful? Looks so nice! Then we just turn it over to do the other side. Now I know you probably don't want to get your fingers messy, you can just press it a little bit, or use a paintbrush to dab it and press it down. And that will get the colour on the other side as well, just so that your fingers aren't too messy if you don't like to get messy. So both sides have been coloured in. Then what you'll need to do is put it somewhere to dry. Now, because it is quite wet because it's mixed with shaving foam, it might take a long time. This one took 2 hours to dry, so give yourself a little bit of time in between. Once it's dry, all you have to do then is use a little bit of card, or you could colour in some letters that say NHS, or you might want to draw a mask, it's up to you, or a love heart, and then you can colour them in or decorate them, and all I did was stick them on top, and when it's all dry, it will look like this. Okay, thank you, have fun, bye.